Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you cannot afford to miss. And this week, we will try and create a game using the new Gemini 2.5 Pro, the most intelligent model from Google. The MCP train is not slowing down. I'll explain what it is and why OpenAI are supporting it. And talking about OpenAI, we'll talk about the most advanced AI image generator yet. It's like working hand in hand with a graphic designer, making minor or major tweaks to things like thumbnails. You can make infographics, memorial coins, and well, so much more. People are having so much fun with it. And we'll look at that later in the video. Quick one, and this requires a change of shirt. The channel is 1 year old today. So thank you so much for joining me if you're new and sticking with me from the start when it looked like I was just talking to crickets, as there was no activity on the channel until at least 6 months of consistently putting stuff out on YouTube. So thank you so much for that. I also noticed looking inside YouTube Studio that actually 73.7% of you that watch are still not subscribed. So please, subscribe! With that said, I don't want to waste your time. I want to get straight into it. I got an email from GitHub Spark saying I've got access to the technical preview. Okay, simple as that. Clicking the confirmation in the email and I'm in. What do you want to create? So I assume this builds little apps for you, and it's got some settings here where you can choose from Claude Sonnet 3.5, I note, not 3.7, GPT-4.0, 01 Preview, and 01 Mini. Okay, for my first app, I'm going to say create an app that shows the most popular videos on Creator Magic YouTube over the past 1 year and uses AI to suggest new ideas. Now, I'm not sure if GitHub Spark connects to the internet or not, so I'm actually going to paste in the CSV file of my figures and viewing stuff so that this can hopefully get to work. And it does say over here that it's cooking up something good, so we'll leave it to it. And we can see over here, we've got a history. It's writing out an index, also some JavaScript, which is cool. There's the ability to change themes in the app. I love the look of this. Very user-friendly. And prompts here, let's have a look at that. Based on the successful titles, suggest a new engaging video. Cool. So it's actually using AI inside the app to self-improve. So we'll let it go ahead and write out all of this code, and hopefully we'll get something cool. Just going to also prompt it not to show the revenue, as much as I love you. Okay, it's going over and just refining my Spark. Cool. So we've got total views here, 3.1 million, and total subscribers, just over 125,000. Let's click generate video idea. And look at that. Wow. AI video suggestion. Unlock your productivity. 7 AI tools that will change how you work forever. Not bad. Let's try another one. I love the glow around the button. That is super cool. Let's try it again. Look at that glow. That's cool. And it keeps coming up with different ideas. So this can create a basic app for you, GitHub Spark. But what I really like over here is it's giving me ideas as to what I can also add to my Spark. What about this one? Add a chart showing view trends over time. So we'll click that. I don't even need to prompt it. It's suggesting me how to prompt and improve my app. And immediately it goes through and rewrites. Okay, very cool. It's created me a chart, but clearly it's got no data to put in that chart, so it's left it blank. But you can see how you can iterate, add hover tooltips to the chart, add a feature to compare performance. This is cool. I guess I can also change the theme. So if I'm not digging this, I can go for like a tomato theme, and look at how quick it is to update. I can go for, let's go for mint. Mint and tomato. That's the secondary accent there. We can choose fonts as well, so we can quickly mix that up. If we want a different look of fonts, we can choose how we fill things, whether it's going to be squared off or like fully circular like that. The scale, we can increase the scale. We can make it dark and light and so on. This is really cool. And I love the fact that I can actually go into prompts and refine the prompt that's being given to generate new video ideas here. So while basic and rudimentary, and of course it's not going to be something like Cursor or Windsurf for coding custom apps, GitHub Spark is actually pretty incredible. I hope you enjoyed that quick demo. If you like what you see so far, do throw a like and subscribe for more videos like this weekly. Now let's get into Gemini 2.5 Pro. And actually, if we look here at the LM Arena leaderboard that tests thousands of times per day, we'll see right at the top, Gemini 2.5 Pro Experimental is there, just above Grok and ChatGPT 4.5. In fact, Google dominating the top charts. Can we code with it, and how does it look? That's why I'm going to go into Cursor. Yes, that's right. If we go into the settings cog up here and we click into models, they already support it. Look down here and yes, Gemini 2.5 Pro Experimental. experimental can be ticked and selected over here in the cursor chat. So we'll scroll down and there is Gemini 2.5 Pro experimental ready to go. How exciting. Now, in terms of fairness, a few weeks ago, you may or may not remember, I tried to create games with ChatGPT 4.5 and also the latest Claude 3.7 Sonnet model. You got to see how those turned out. Now I'm going to use the same prompt with Gemini 2.5 Pro Experimental and see what it does. So I'm sending this prompt. It just says, create an office-themed endless runner like Crossy Road, A-hole alley where players dodge co-workers carrying coffee, navigate cubicle mazes, avoid chairs and other obstacles as well. And here we can see Gemini 2.5 Pro Experimental is going to work immediately, planning out what it needs to do and writing a lot of the code very, very quickly. But sadly, what I've noticed here on my first prompt is it didn't create the code. It gave me samples of the code, but I don't see any files created over here. Not a great start. So I'm going to mix things up here and install Ada. Now, I've never used Ada on the channel before. It's a free and open source command line AI coding tool, and we'll get it installed using these commands right here now. Couple of commands and we're up and running. Let's get Gemini 2.5 Pro working with Ada. And again, they've already got a tutorial for that right here in their documentation. Wow, it really was as easy as that to get Ada up and running. And now you'll see at the command line, after saying I don't want to git repo and I don't want to see what's new, I just have a simple prompt. Now here I can paste in my command that I did in cursor earlier about the Crossy Road style game I want created. We can see that the API is under quite some demand right now from Google. Sadly, I kept hitting rate limits via Ada when calling Gemini 2.5 Pro via API. So I resorted to Google AI Studio to generate the code and paste it in manually. Let's make sure the model we choose is actually Gemini 2.5 Pro. So you can see here, first of all, it's starting by thinking through how it's going to make the game. Now, I have to say, I didn't see any of this happening inside Cursor or Ada. So maybe it's better for now, while this is experimental, to run it directly in Google AI Studio. Obviously, I'll link that and all the other tools down below in the description to this video. Now, as I talk, it's been thinking away for 23 or so seconds, not even written code yet, but when it does, we'll copy it all and try it out. And here it comes. And there you go, just over 2 minutes, and it completed 123.3 seconds to write the full game. So while Gemini 2.5 Pro is not ready for prime time, even though Cursor and Ada and I'm sure other AI no-code tools are integrating it, it seems to be that Google AI Studio is the place to use it and sadly copy and paste the code. Okay, here it is. Let's try. Oh, wow. Okay, something is going on here. I'm not quite sure how to get through and it's crashing on me, but it is working somehow and it's kind of 3D, but it kind of crashes after a little while. Unlike my other thing, oh, I can crash into something. And yes, I did get a game over. So this is looking quite promising in a way. It won't let me try again. Let's try one more time. Here are some things to dodge. They don't look like coffee cups or co-workers. But yeah, I can see the initial idea of a game is there. Google Gemini 2.5 Pro, definitely not ready for the prime time, not ready for production stuff right now. You can't do the agentic coding inside Cursor. It didn't work from Ada on the command line. I kept getting that the API was overloaded and I was exhausting my uses. And then when I copy and pasted from Google AI Studio, I kind of got something that didn't work. And then after three prompts, something that did work but wasn't very good. So that's my experience so far. Maybe you'll have a different experience, and do let me know in the comments down below if you do. Okay, next up, this is really cool. OpenAI started to support MCP. That's been the buzz around here recently, but you'll see if you read the instructions here, there are some end-to-end examples linked. Okay, let's go ahead and run the first AI agent from OpenAI that will use MCP. Read files and list them. It's looking at this sample files directory. What is my number one favorite book? It's asking. If we look at the file, it should be To Kill a Mockingbird. Will it get it? And it did, To Kill a Mockingbird. Look at my favorite songs. Suggest a song I would like. And if we look here, here are some of them. And you can see it said, you might enjoy Sir Duke by Stevie Wonder. Now, I'm also going to take a look at this Git example one as well. And it seems I can run that pretty easily too. Okay, it's asking for the path to a Git repository. So let's put in the OpenAI agent's path and it'll ask who's the most frequent contributor. Let's see if the agent gets it right using MCP. And the answer is Rohan Mehta. There we go. And what have we got here? Summarize the last change in the repo. It was by Stephen Heidel on the 26th of March, 2025. Expose the store parameter through model settings. Wow, look at that. We are using OpenAI Agents SDK and MCP. This is definitely the future of AI interacting with everything. Okay, finally, we're in trusty ChatGPT, and we're actually going to change the model from GPT-01 to GPT-40 because everyone has been raving about ChatGPT-40 image generation. It's pretty insane. The text possibilities are crazy, swapping faces and more, all possible. So here I'm actually going to attach a couple of images from my computer. And here we've got a Mr. Beast thumbnail, one of his recent thumbnails, and a picture of me. So let's go ahead and add those to the context. And as the prompt here, I'm just going to say, swap the face on this YouTube thumbnail to be this person. And hopefully it will swap out Mr. Beast for me using the new ChatGPT-40 image generation. Okay, wow, I'm loving what I see so far. That is pretty incredible. Make a colorful comic-style infographic that describes MCP, and I want it to use four different points. And these are four very simplistic points that describe MCP. Now, I've given it a lot of information there. It's getting started right away. I'm really curious to see what it will come up with. Wow, there we go. This is awesome in terms of explainer infographics. A little bit text heavy, but I'm not going to really slate it on that. It did say APPIs instead of APIs, but again, can easily be corrected with another prompt or in Photoshop. I love what is done here. And this is something cool that I saw them do in the OpenAI demo itself. I'm going to add my photo and also the Creator Magic logo as two uploaded elements. And I'm going to say create a memorial coin based on these assets. Use hex code FFB02E, which is the Creator Magic theme color, and put the text Creator Magic 2025. That is really cool. Now, the face isn't there, but the logo is in both photos, so it kind of looks like it's prioritized that. Let's prompt it again. That is absolutely incredible. Oh my goodness. Never have I been so taken aback by AI image generation. Actually, that is equivalent to a Midjourney moment. The first time I typed a prompt into Midjourney and got exactly what I asked for back, this is like that, but times by 10. Make a transparent background. I really appreciate you watching every week. I'm grateful that you're there. And by the way, YouTube is showing a video on your screen right now that you should watch next. And there you go, you see it's made the coin. Maybe my face has degraded a bit in quality, but that is now on a transparent background.